the gold. They fear no foe as they hit them low. Let's give them all three mighty cheers. Rah, rah, rah! Here's the fighting team, boys, that fights for old Purdue. With loyal hearts we will play our parts as we yell for old Purdue. Here's the fighting varsity that wears the black and the gold. They fear no foe as they hit them low. Let's give them all three mighty cheers. Rah, rah, rah! Here's the fighting team, boys, that fights for old Purdue. With loyal hearts we will play our parts as we yell for old Purdue.
In only his second season at the helm of Purdue basketball, head coach Fred Schaus led the 1974 Boilermakers to a 21-9 record, including wins over such teams as 14th-ranked Michigan, number 9 Providence, and number 8 North Carolina. Purdue's 9 losses came by an average of merely 6.1 points, and the Boilermakers' third-place finish in the Big Ten helped earn a bid to the NIT tournament. The 1974 roster included 6'11" John Garrett, who led Purdue in scoring at 21.6 points per game. David Luke was the quick defensive specialist, while sophomore Bruce Parkinson had already broken every assist record in the Boilermaker annals. Purdue's bench seemed to get the Boilermakers through their toughest games with the help of big men Jerry Nichols and Tom Scheffler, while freshman Gerald Thomas, Mike Steele, and walk-on Dick Satterfield provided solid play. Other bench men included Tom Gilbert, Randy Shields, Dan McDermott, Bob McCarter, and Pat Manahan. Indispensable six-man Bruce Rose frustrated opponents with his game in the corner, and Purdue's own MVP Frank Kendrick rounded out the lineup, averaging a double-double on the season with 18.5 points and 10.1 rebounds per contest. No one really considered Purdue a legitimate contender as they opened the tournament against number 8 North Carolina, but Nichols' 22 points and a relentless Boilermaker defense solidified the upset 82-71. Neither Purdue's next two opponents posed any real threat, as the Boilermakers bested both Hawaii and Jacksonville by 13 and 15 points. Purdue had once before squared off against its NIT title game opponent, losing to Utah in an 87-85 thriller only 3 months earlier. In the championship game, the Utes took early control, leading by as many as 9 points, but Utah's 12 first-half turnovers helped Purdue climb within 5 to close the half. Kendrick and Garrett combined for 49 points on the night and sparked a 12-4 Boilermaker run to take the lead. Utah knotted the score at 72 with 5 minutes left, but it was reserve Mike Steele who nailed a bucket with 3:20 left to play for a 4-point advantage Purdue would not relinquish. The 87-81 victory made the 1974 Boilermakers the first Big Ten team to capture an NIT championship. Kendrick, an all-conference selection, was named to the all-tourney team, while Coach Schaus's Purdue team finished 11th in the Associated Press poll.
There was kind of a hush. All over this arena,
all over the Hoosiers world tonight as they fall in overtime. 18 for Austin, 14 in the second half, and the overtime, including the game winner. So Purdue wins the Battle of Indiana. For Len Elmore, Dave Barnett, thanks for being with us for this classic. This has been a presentation of ESPN The World.
With Penn State in town, assistant coach Frank Kendrick reminded the Boilers about what had happened in the Lions' den.
Final analysis, they may have cost you a ring. We won't know that until it's all over, but there's a damn good chance that they may have cost you a ring. But you got a chance to do something about it. You got a chance to get them back.
Come along, let us join in our song. Hail to old Purdue. Follow what action says with the welcome and present all the waters to.
Instead, wave the